I'll be discussing 10th problem. So following is the balance sheet of A company as on 31st March 2015. So buildings, machinery, stock, debtors and bank balance. So 1,20,000 shares of rupees 10 each, reserve fund, development rebate reserve. As you all know, it is a statutory reserve. Creditors and profit and loss account. So let us move to the additional information. The concern is acquired by B Limited. So B Limited is transferee company and A Limited is transferor company. The PC being the payment of rupees 10 lakh in cash and allotment of 2 fully paid shares of rupees 10 each at an agreed price of rupees 12 rupees 50 paise. So share premium is 2 rupees 50 paise. In exchange for every 3 shares of A Limited. So for every 3 shares, how many shares of transferee company is issued? 2 shares. So look into the calculation here. For every 3 shares, 2 shares have been issued. Therefore, how many shares are there in transferor company? 1,20,000. This you will get it in balance sheet. So how many shares? 80,000 shares. So 80,000 shares are issued at 12 rupees 50 paise. This you can show it, split it up. So 80,000 into 10 and 80,000 into 2 rupees 50 paise. 2 rupees 50 paise is the premium and 10 rupees is the face value. So totally you get 10 lakh. And the cash paid is rupees 10 lakh. The total PC will be 20 lakh. In cash 10 lakh. In shares of our transferee company 10 lakh. So therefore total PC will come to 20 lakh. Now coming on to the next additional information. The liquidation expenses of the Venda company is rupees 15,000. Venda company is nothing but selling company. That is transferor company, A company. So you have only one journal entry that will appear in realization account. The journal entry will be realization account data to cash account 15,000. So they have asked you to show the necessary journal entries to record the above in the books of both the companies. So you have to pass closing entries in the books of transferor company and opening entries in the books of transferee company under which method? Purchase method. Assume that development rebate reserve will continue for 3 more years in transferee company. Now we'll move on to the journal entries. So this is the journal entries that appear in the books of transferor company. First journal entry will be for transfer of assets. Realization account data to concerned assets account. Second journal entry will be for transfer of liabilities. So what are the liabilities that you have? Development, rebate reserve and creditors. So you just remember that we are working out the problem under purchase method. Under purchase method, only those assets and liabilities are taken over and all liabilities are not taken over. Here you have two types of reserves, reserve fund and development rebate reserve. Under purchase method, we are going to consider only development rebate reserve. So only development rebate reserve will be transferred here. So look here, creditors account, development rebate reserve account to realization account. Now what are the items that are left over here? Shares, reserve fund and profit and loss account. So these three items should be transferred to equity shareholders account. So this is the difference between purchase method and merger method. Under merger method, only equity share capital account was showed as amount due to equity shareholders. That is the journal entry would be equity share capital account data to equity shareholders account. But in purchase method, so the journal entry will be reserve fund account data, creditors account data, profit and loss account data to equity shareholders account. Now the third journal entry would be for PC due. So transferee company account data to realization account. And then the PC received. So it is received both in the form of cash and equity shares. So cash 10 lakh, equity shares 10 lakh. Next journal entry will be for the payment of realization expenses which is paid by transferor company. As I have already discussed while discussing the adjustment, it is realization account data to cash account 15,000. Now you have realization profit, so realization account data to equity shareholders account. So 1,19,720. If you get negative, it will be profit. If you get positive, it will be loss. Now as I told you, The amount should be shown as due to the equity shareholders. So now listen here. So the whatever amount was left over on the liability side of balance sheet that I told you, share capital, reserve fund and profit and loss account, should be transferred to equity shareholders account, because this is purchase method. If it were to be merger method, we used to transfer only share capital account data to equity shareholders account. Why? Because these two reserves were taken by, would have been taken by transferee company. So this is the difference between merger and purchase. Next generative would be for the final settlement made to equity shareholders. So equity shareholders account data to equity shares in B company, how much we are paying? 10 lakh. So to cash account. So to cash account, how much we are paying? The amount available is only rupees 9,85,000. Actually, we were supposed to pay 10 lakh, but the amount available is only 9,85,000. So the total is 19,85,000 is the amount of final settlement made to the equity shareholders. Now coming to balance sheet. So this, opening entries. So this is the opening entries in the books of transferee company. As you all know, first generative will be for PCDU. Business purchase account data to liquidator of A account, so 20 lakh. So now the next journal entry would be for the incorporation of assets and liabilities taken over. So since this is a problem on amalgamation in the nature of purchase, the balancing figure should be transferred to goodwill account. So you have building, machinery, stock, debtors, bank account, two concerned liabilities account. So you have creditors account. But you have one more item taken over, which is development rebate reserve, statutory reserve. So in case of amalgamation in the nature of purchase, a separate general entry should be passed for statutory reserve, as I've already told you. So what is the general entry? Amalgamation adjustment account data to development rebate reserve account. So two creditors account you have 2 lakh, two business purchase 20 lakh. So balancing figure will be 1,22,220, which is nothing but goodwill. So this adjustment I told you for the statutory reserve. So amalgamation adjustment account will come on the asset side of the balance sheet, and development rebate reserve will appear on the liability side of the balance sheet under the head reserves and surplus. The last general entry would be for final settlement, that is the PC paid. So the PC should be paid to the liquidator. So general entry will be liquidator of A company account data to cash 10 lakh, and then to share capital 8 lakh, and to securities premium 2 lakh, which I have already discussed in PC calculation. With this, we will complete this problem.